Hello everybody, I am Stéphanie Targhy from the Muséum National d'Histoire Naturelle in France. Thanks a lot Stereopsia and Image du Réel for your kind invitation. I'm going to talk about how we aspire to use immersion to tell the story of nature and also how we aim to generate some revenues to amortize our investment in this field as the first step. First, let's see a video of the museum. The Muséum National d'Histoire Naturelle presents a unique synergy of missions in the world. Scientific research, scientific expertise, acquisition and conservation of collections, education, dissemination of knowledge. Centered around Earth's geological and biological diversity, cultural and societal diversity, and our planet's history. 2,500 people are working at the museum. More than 570 scientists, 500 students. We host 67 million of natural history specimens in 13 sites in France, museums, botanical gardens, and zoos, where every year we welcome 8 million visitors. An expression dear to the heart of our president Bruno David is marvel to educate. As you may have discovered in this video, the Muséum National d'Histoire Naturelle hosts a variety of places. Let's see them. Yes, so a variety of places in France. Actually, 13 museums, galleries, botanical gardens and zoos, like the Jardin des Plantes in the center of Paris. I would like to show you the Jardin des Plantes. Yes. The Grande Galerie de l'Évolution, Great Gallery of Evolution inside the Jardin des Plantes. The Gallery of Paleontology and Anatomy Comparée. The greenhouses of the Jardin des Plantes, and the menagerie, a small zoo inside the Jardin des Plantes also. Still in Paris, here is the Musée de l'Homme as a museum of mankind in front of the Eiffel Tower, as you can see. Here is still the Musée de l'Homme, and the Paris Zoo on the east side of Paris. Other around 10 places in France, in Brittany, in the south of France. Okay. At the Musée de l'Homme and at the Natural History Museum, we work to reconnect human being with nature. To pursue this goal, we believe in the power of immersion to create emotional experiences, to marvel, to engage our visitors. This is where VR comes in. We initiated our first VR experience in 2016. We had the opportunity to drive this innovation thanks to a collaboration with our sponsor, Orange. At that time, we couldn't have done it without the financial and technological support of a sponsor. It's very clear. Orange teams were working on VR, and I was convinced, as I looked at our pair's accomplishment around the world, that there was something here in VR really interesting for us in Natural History Museum. Because we are working on a reality. Natural reality, I mean at the museum, like natural reality. Environment and species are the subjects of our research. They constitute our collections and our exhibitions. Virtual reality is the perfect medium to augment this sensation of reality and offer unique time and space travels to our visitors, like going back in time to meet dinosaurs or exploring the natural world from the abyss to the canopy of primary forests, and also conceive abstract representation as the tree of life we presented in our first VR program, Journey into the Art of Evolution. Let's have a look to it and to the cabinet of virtual reality we have created at this occasion. So this immersive experience invites the VR visitor to explore the tree of life. To display this experience, we created the first permanent VR room in a museum in France, the Cabinet de Réalité Virtuelle. 6 stations equipped with HTC Vive headsets in a 90 square meters. The visitor dive into the tree of life and discover iconic species and how they are related to each other. The space is modular and it can evolve according to our needs. Each station measures 9 square meters. The design of the room wants to be natural, minimalist, and timeless, a space of calm in contrast with the visual and sonore diversity of the Grande Galerie de l'Évolution. It's important to remember that in 2017, the decision to build a permanent VR room in a museum in France was quite risky. We didn't have any comparative model, but an innovative VR content, this one, and a desire to create the best setting to present it to our audience. About the exploitation, the virtual reality cabinet is open on Wednesday, Saturday, Sunday, and every day during the public holidays. We opened the cabinet de réalité virtuelle in December 2017, and we have amortized the investment 2 years later in 2019, thanks to the ticketing. €5, a price to add to the ticket of the permanent exhibition. When I say we amortized it, I am talking about the investment in the room, the space itself, because HTC, Vive, and Dell were our sponsors for the headsets and the computers. And Orange was a sponsor for the content. So clearly, we invested in two posts, the conception of the building, of the room, sorry, and the human resources. Two hosts are welcoming the visitors, present them the program, and help when needed. The salary of those two hosts are engaged on our permanent resources. So the investment in 2017 was in the room, and that's what we amortized 2 years later in 2019. We are now looking for opportunities to develop this kind of spaces in other sites like the Musée de l'Homme and the Paris Zoo. From a 2020 perspective, some choice will be different, like typically, we would like to have self-service system and software for 360 movie and six stuff experiences. The dimension of self-service system is really important for us. Concerning the content, A Journey into the Art of Evolution as a sponsored program is supposed to be distributed free of charge in different versions, HTC Vive, Oculus Go, and we are now in discussion with new partners to adapt it to Quest 2 and Lenovo headsets. But we also encourage the co-production of other versions, like other language. For instance, our partnership with the University of Chile in Santiago include the translation of the experience in Spanish. We also want to evolve the content with new functionalities. Now, what happened since this first program? Here are some examples of other experiences we are working on. First one, the Starry Sand Beach, a VR project by Nina Barbier and Xing Sheng Wang, produced by Lucid Realities in co-production with the museum, supported by the CNC in France and Taika in Taiwan. It is a real-time 3D interactive VR. Mixing art and science, the scientific tale uses the poetic legend of the starry sand to make us understand the role of the foraminifera and the dangers that are facing the oceans. The project is now in production and will be launched next spring. Other museums are already interested for a presentation next fall. Yet, we are still looking for other partnerships to build. This co-production is going to be the case study to build an economic model for VR content. Another project we are working on, still with lucid realities actually, is Darwin at the Origin of the Origins. It's a VR series here in 4 episodes that follows Charles Darwin's first trip around the world and shows how his observation and discoveries have changed the way we are looking at it. And actually, we are looking at ourselves. Co-production Museum and Lucid Realities, as I said, in partnership with the University of Chile in Santiago, in the perspective of displaying the content in the future immersive museum of evolution. We are currently in an early stage working on the first script and very open to build international partnerships. We are also working on AR programs like this one. This one is called Revivre. From May 2021, Revivre will be presented at the Museum National d'Histoire Naturelle, produced by Saola in co-production with the museum. This experience will take place in the Grande Galerie de l'Évolution, the same place where is the Cabinet of Virtual Reality. The spectator will be invited to visit the Instinct Species Gallery. Equipped with AR glasses, they will discover for the first time some of these modeled and animated species evolving in an original scenario. The model here is also a co-production. The museum will share the benefits with the co-producer, Saola. What's next? Immersive exhibitions. One of our next major exhibition will be an immersive journey from the equator to the pole using technologies that allows us to immerse ourselves and interact in environments, observe, discover, act, and smell. This exhibition that the museum's teams have co-designed with our partner Sensory Odyssey will be presented in 1 year's time at the Jardin des Plantes. Here again, the model is a co-production. The museum will share the risk, but also the benefits with the co-producer Sensory Odyssey. So you see, we are really exploring this model of co-production for VR, AR, and immersive exhibitions. This model includes potential collaboration with foreign cultural venues like museums, art science centers, cultural centers in general, who share with us this interest for nature and its preservation. And we are looking for entertaining, poetic, but also serious and fact-checked programs signed by a scientific institution. We would work with their local ecosystem, the producers, creative studios, public funds, private partners, technological or financial, schools, libraries, as our partner would work with our own local French ecosystem. So feel free to contact me if you want to engage a conversation about those initiatives or to share any idea or any project. Thank you very much.